right here in the Great Mickey Mouse shirt.
Hi Jason, I'm JT from Spin of Big Music.
Hi,
my question is, you've had some major collaborations on your latest album, Megan, J-Lo, Keith, and the legendary Stevie Wonder. Your relationship with this amazing artist?
Each artist is very different. Every person on the album has one thing in common. I'm a fan of everybody on the album. I really wanted things to happen organically, you know. So the Stevie Wonder situation was just us both having dinner at the White House and just starting to get a conversation going, and that happened through that conversation. J-Lo, I was working on her new project, you know, writing some stuff for her new stuff, and that happened organically as well. Megan is, you know, is an absolute sweetheart. We really got on as soon as we met, so you know, it was only natural that we would do a song again. So I mean, every situation was just totally different, but it was all organic. You know, it was not like I was like, I think this person would be amazing on this song. It happened naturally, which I think is way better.
I love how you casually were like,
yeah. Oh, we had met him at the White House.
That's no big deal, you guys. You know, just chatting with Stevie Wonder at the White House. Obama was there, but you know, he wasn't in. All right, guys, next question over here in the back.
Hello, Jason. I'm Mina from H Live.
Hey.
Every time you sing, every time most of your songs, you always have this signature, like, Jason Derulo.
How was that again?
We always do that. Like, how did it happen? Like, yeah.
One night, what happened was I was dreaming about this. Really sexy woman. There's no story behind it. I mean, I was a new artist, and I wanted my name to get out there. So I was like, what would be a cool tag? And I was just in a booth, and I just kind of just saying my name. I didn't think it was like this big revolutionary thing, but it kind of took the world by storm. For some reason, the jingle was something that really stuck in people's minds. I mean, it's not the first time somebody's said their name in a song. And certainly won't be the last time, but I think it was just the actual melody that stuck in people's minds. But I don't do it anymore. It is retired. But it was nice to hear you sing it.
All right, another question.
Hello, Jason. My name is Georgie. I'm from Berlin Metro.
What's up, Georgie?
Good. Okay, my question is, do you listen to newcomers, and who are you currently listening to?
Do I what?
Do you listen to newcomers?
I do try to stay up on what's new and popping and fresh. So yeah, I do listen to new artists. The newest album that I've been checking out is the Travis Scott album. He's a newcomer, kinda. So yeah, you know, I try to keep my ear to the street. That's how we say it in Miami. You just keep your ear to the street to see what's bubbling. Especially because I have a record label. I'm a 50-50 partner with RCA Sony. So I'm constantly looking for the newest big thing, so to speak. So yeah.
You know, quick follow up. Is there anybody up and coming who you're like, yeah, I could collaborate with?
Not in particular, no.
And we waited.
Yeah, I mean, to me, like I said, like organically, like anything can happen. Like there's a song on my album called Trading Hearts, and it has a young lady on the song that the world has never heard before, and I just thought she's just sounded so beautiful. So there was nobody that I feel like could have replaced her voice. So I was like, will you please stay on the song? And she didn't know whether she wanted to stay on the song because she doesn't want to be an artist. She repels being an artist. She's like, I'm like, the world needs to hear you. Like, you're incredible. Like, the world needs to hear this. So yeah, she finally reneged, and she's on my album.
Rest is history.
Rest is history.
All right, guys, next question right here.
Hi Jason, I'm from Dusan, Malaysia. Can you describe yourself in five words?
terrible at those. You know, because I mean, 5 words, I really can't describe myself in 5 words, honestly. I am the shit, that's 4. I am the shit, man.
Something that plays on the back of your mind, and how hard do you go in during rehearsals and on stage now?
It all seems like a bad dream, man, at this point. I went through a crazy recovery. I mean, the recovery was like 7 months, and at the beginning I couldn't do the simplest things like, you know, tie my own shoe or put my own shirt on. So it was a rough time, but a time that I feel like I needed. Like that whole section of my life helped me become the man I am today. And who I am today is somebody who lives every day like it's their last day. Like, I'm always trying to have a good time for whatever I'm doing, even when I'm doing conferences like this. You know, I'm making sure that I'm having a great time. So excuse me for all the crazy things that I say.
You ain't got to apologize.
But yeah, it's all about, man, like, living your life to the fullest. You know, I could have been gone in an instant. You know, it was a near-death experience, and I got a second chance. So I decided to really use this second chance to make a difference in the world, and to also make sure that I was living life to the fullest.
Great answer.
Thanks, man.
All right.
I forgot what the question was.
Me too. I was just in the answer. All right, question back here. Yes?
Hi, Jason. My name's Shah. I'm from The Stars Online TV, thestartv.com.
Hey, what's up, bro?
Right. We just heard you work with some of the biggest names in the music industry, but is there one particular artist which you really want to work with, but you haven't had a chance to work with? And have you ever considered collaborating with an Asian singer in a song? Thank you.
I think, for me, man, I'm so content at doing songs myself. Having somebody else be on the song is just like an awesome bonus, you know. I'm totally okay with just being a fan and allowing other people to do what they do and watch from a distance. But at the same token, I do love being in the studio with other talented people. I mean, it's almost like playing basketball with your friend. You know, I think it's always fly to work with somebody that you have a connection with. Stevie Wonder is somebody that I've always watched growing up. You know, he was an inspiration of mine, and he happened to be one of the nicest, funniest guys in the world. You know, so to have those two things married together and be in the studio with a legend, that was incredible to me. But if I met a legend, right, and he's someone that I always watched and I didn't have an incredible experience verbally. Like, I don't know if I would have that same connection in the studio, let alone me wanting to do a song with that kind of person. You know, certain people have, like, little egos, and I can't really deal with egos very well because I got a bad temper. So, like, if you say something crazy to me, like, we gonna be going at it. So, you know, I think things need to happen organically. At this stage in my career, man, it's all about doing what I love. Because I love it. I started doing music because I love it. So, you know, there has to be some kind of connection there.
Hi, Jason. My name is Vasanta, and I'm from Female Manager.